Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. My name is Muhammad Hamza Tariq and I am from University of Engineering and Technology, Texas. Today, I am going to present my article with the title of Effect of Al-Quran on Human Physiology. This is the content that I am going to cover in my presentation today, which include the introduction, literature survey, methodology, result, and conclusion. Introduction. So, in the recent year, the healthcare through the spiritual healing for the well-being is focused by the researcher. Spiritual healing relates to the religion. It is commonly claimed in all the religious books that chanting its rituals and recitation lead to the better health, well-being, and satisfaction. Meditation is performed in different forms in different religions. Research provided a solid piece of evidence about the meditation that it marks a positive impact on the human health. Similarly, the recitation of Quran is also the meditation, and it is claimed that its recitation can affect the emotional and physiological state of the human. So, our core objective is to investigate the effect of Quranic recitation on the human physiology by analyzing ECG signals before and during listening to the Holy Quran. Literature survey. We have gone through the different articles in order to understand what has been done till now regarding a topic. This slide shows the summary of some of the articles that we have gone through during our detailed literature survey. In 2014, we found the article in which EEG and ECG signal was analyzed. Several features were extracted from the data acquired and the spot vector machine was used for the classification of the data. In 2016, EEG signal was used for the purpose of studying the effect of Quranic recitation on the human being, and the multi-layer preceptor was used for the classification of the system. 85.86% accuracy was achieved by that system. In 2018, heart rate, breathing rate, and level of carbon dioxide was observed of the participants when they were listening to the Quran, and it was compared when they were not listening to the Quran. In 2018, the state rate anxiety level was observed by the researcher, and it was compared when the participants were not listening to the Holy Quran. After our detailed literature survey, we come to a common result that Quranic recitation marks a positive impact on its reciter and its listener. Here's the methodology. Our proposed methodology include the data acquisition, and the second step was pre-processing, and after the pre-processing we extracted the features and finally classification of the data. Data acquisition. Data was acquired from the subject in our departmental lab. We have used MP36 BioPack system for recording the ECG signal. 2450 samples of the ECG signal was gathered when the subject was not listening to the Holy Quran, and 1307 samples when they were listening to the Holy Quran. Table shows a short summary of the data acquisition. Here the time domain and the frequency domain graphs of the ECG signal of both the classes, which are analyzed. Pre-processing. The data acquired from the subject may be contaminated with the artifact and noise. So, the pre-processing is become necessary for the removal of these artifacts. We have used empirical mode decomposition technique for the removal of the noise and for the extraction of our area of interest. EMD decomposes the signal into the independent set of the amplitude and frequency modulated signals known as intrinsic mode function, and has the residual as well. The first IMF has the highest frequency and then it gradually decreases. Firstly, the time domain and the frequency domain signals of the time domain and frequency domain signal of the ECG signal that were acquired from the subject were analyzed. Then the different IMFs were extracted, and IMFs containing the region of interest are selected from the IMFs generated in the process of EMD. After the selection of IMFs, denoise signal is reconstructed. Here is the denoise signal, reconstructed denoise signal. The slide shows the time domain and frequency domain graph of both the classes reconstructed signal. And the final step was, and the second last step of the our proposed methodology is the feature extraction. After obtaining the DNA signal features were extracted. Different combinations were used for attaining the best classification of the data. And finally, we attained the maximum accuracy with the 10 features. These 10 features are mean, skewness, kurtosis, standard deviation, spurious free dynamic range, signal to noise and distortion ratio, impulse factor, crest factor, log energy, and band power. After the extraction of the features, we fed these feature based data into the classification step. We have used the sport vector machine for the classification. Sport vector machine is a supervised machine learning algorithm. For the non-linear dataset, the kernel version of SVMs are used. SVM classifies the hyperplane that separates the data. It uses the hyperplane that separates the dataset. SVM is the most popularly used for the classification in the physiological signal. Results. Scatter plot, result includes scatter plot, confusion, class-wise accuracy, and accuracy comparison. Results. This paper has presented the model to study the effect of chronic recitation on the listener's physiology through the signal processing technique. We have applied EMD for the extraction of the area of region of interest, and detailed analysis for the feature extraction was performed. First of all, we attained 81% accuracy by using SVM cubic when we have used 44 features. Then after analysis, we got 91.6 accuracy with cubic SVM at the range of 10 features, and successfully we classified our system into the respective classes with accuracy of 91.6 by using SVM through the 5-fold cross validation. This is a scatter plot between the signal to noise and distortion, signal to noise and distortion ratio, and kurtosis. Here is the confusion matrix. We show the true classes and the prediction classes of our system. This is a class-wise accuracy. Here is the accuracy comparison of the different. Here is the class-wise accuracy of the different classifier that we have used. Here is the conclusion. It is concluded that listening to the Holy Quranic recitation can introduce the variation in the human physiology. The outcome of the system provided necessary evidence that the ECG signal analysis can also be an opportunity to observe the physiological changes other than EEG. In the future, we have a plan to study the effect of chronic recitation on the listeners through the photoplethysmograph. I am very thankful to you guys for your precious time.